What I've done today, it really exceeded everything that I had in mind so far. Having something in mind that could allow us to clip and to check different clip configurations and so on. Congratulations, very good, very nice. I think it's very realistic. The more realistic, the better. So, and realistically means you have to sit and watch and look through the microscope, same positioning, same instrument, same clip. And the only difference is that it's a model behind and below the clip, and it's not a patient. The technology is evolving, and we will have with this the most realistic model to clip different animals and configurations. The other models, they are steps forward. And they are improvements, but I think this one is the most realistic in terms of, you know, exchanging different configurations and having being as close as possible to the surgical daily work. Clip with different configuration of clips to learn a lot about how others do. I think this is something that we will, in the age of endovascular surgery and still having 1/3 of complicated aneurysm maybe left all the time for clipping. But you still can learn if you see a different configuration of your colleague and you say, wow, this was convincing, compelling, and I always do it like this, but sometimes I should do it like he does. So learning in this level is also seeing and improving from others' work. But if you're getting trained, it's more important. Experience always comes also from bad results, so you can maybe skip the bad results. If you learn with a simulator. A lot of these experiences that you have in the 1,000 cases, you need to be good, really good, that you can take a lot of this training effect using the model. We have the discussion also in the European Society about fellows or training instead of fellows, our own doctors. So there are two groups exchanging discussions. I also believe in subspecialized trainings. For residents in general, they can play with it. But for the few cerebrovascular surgeons that really get the training and to become a cerebrovascular neurosurgeon, then this is the right way to do it. You know, I was longing for years to see it. Now I see it and I'm happy that it's there. And now we have to turn it into practical knowledge for residents. Have something, a tool that can help us to get there.
Let's go.